Welcome to Office 2013 class video number 44. Hey, if you want to download this workbook and follow along, click on the link below the video or go to our class website. Hey, we're still studying Excel. This is Excel Basics 26. And we want to talk about the if function. Now, lots of people think the if function is hard. But guess what? It's not. It's very simple. The if function is for putting one of two things in a cell. Now we're going to start with a bonus example. And here's you. You sold $65,000 for the period. And your contract says if you sell more than $50,000, you get $500 extra as a bonus. So check this out. If this is the cell in your payroll spreadsheet where they put your bonus, right? There's only two numbers that can go here. 65,000, since you're bigger than the hurdle, you get 500. Notice, what do we put in this cell? 500. Now, what a bummer. You only sold 10,000. Uh-oh. Well, that's not bigger than 50,000, so you get 0. Next period, you sell 75,000. Oh, well, here's the cell where you either get your bonus or not. So now you get 500. Next period, you sell $1. Well, now you get a 0. That's it. That's what the if function will do for us. If you have a cell in your spreadsheet that's only going to get one of two things, and the two things here are 0 or 500, then forget doing it manually. You want to do it with the if function. Now I'm going to put 65,000. We'll start back right where we started and delete this. Now before we can do the if function, we have to remind ourselves what a logical formula is. Now earlier in the class, we saw a logical formula. Well, all a logical formula is something that tells you true or false. Did you exceed or equal the hurdle? Now notice I said, are your sales, did they exceed, that means bigger, or is it equal to? Because you get your bonus if you're exactly 50,000. So really you could say it this way, is 65,000 greater than or equal to 50,000? Well, what's the answer? It's true. What if I change this to $1? Is $1 greater than or equal to 50,000? False. Well, that's an example of a logical test. Now, we don't ever want to have to do it by hand. We want formulas to do it for us. So watch this. What's the character that tells Excel we're going to do a formula? It's the equal sign. But notice, it's the equal sign as the very first character in the cell. So now, I ask the question, are your sales? And now we have to use a comparative operator. Here's a list of the comparative operators. We've looked at this a few times in our class. Greater than or equal to, there's no single character, so you have to type greater than or equal two characters. Then you click on the bonus. That's a question, a logical test. Are your sales greater than or equal to the bonus? Well, of course, we're going to get false. But as soon as we change it to 65,000, boom, true. Now, anytime you have a test that has an operator and an equal sign, what are we going to do? We're going to check to see if our logical formula is working. Below, well, I'm just going to give it $1. Well, it gave me a false. Way above, great, we had 75,000. And you have to check exactly right on. Remember, your contract says if you sell exactly 50,000, that means you equal the hurdle, you get the bonus. I love it. True means I get, or no, these are your sales. You get the 500 bucks. All right, so that's a logical formula. Why did we do this before doing the if? Because the if function uses a logical formula. So now let's come down to this cell. Here's the big moment. The if function equals if. And look at this. There's three arguments. Logical test, that's our logical formula. And whatever you put there has got to come out true or false. And then the rest of it is, hey, value if true, what do you want me to put in the cell if it's true? And then value if false, that's what you want me to put in the cell if this comes out false. So our logical test, are your sales greater than or equal to the hurdle? If that's true, we type a comma. And the value of true, well, what do we want? 500. Otherwise, we type a comma. What's the value of false? Since it's always going to be 0, we just type it in. Notice that's the thing that goes into the cell. If that logical test comes out false, that's the thing that goes into the cell if this comes out true. Remember, the if puts one of two things in the cell, 500 or 0. Now I'm going to close parentheses, and here we go. Control Enter. 500, I love it. Now let's test this. Oh, I only sold one. Or even worse, 49,999.99. Oh, this would be a bummer. 1 penny shy. But no problem. They rounded it up to the dollar, so it's 50,000. Boom, we got the bonus. 100,000, or whatever number is bigger, we got the bonus.
The if function.
Putting one of two things in the cell. Now let's look at another example. Over here we have debits and credits, and they always have to be in balance. But hey, we're human. I see number formatting. Maybe there's a problem. Guess what? Formulas won't get tricked by this number formatting. So anytime you have numbers that have to be in balance, a logical formula or an if function off to the side to verify that everything's in balance is a good idea. So let's just say equals. Hey, that tells Excel I'm doing a formula. Is that cell equal to, and that's a comparative operator, this cell? The first equal sign says I'm doing a formula. The second one is a comparative operator saying, are you equal? Control Enter, false. Now, we've gone over this a lot in this class. Immediately, when we see this, we have to investigate. We probably know by now that the eraser for number formatting, general number formatting. And sure enough, boom, there's an extra penny somewhere. So as soon as your formula says false, you go and investigate. Now I'm going to Control Z. Sometimes we don't want false, right? We want to say in balance or not in balance. So this is an example of a cell that's going to get one of two text strings or phrases, either in balance or not in balance. So I'm going to use the if function. The logical test, something that comes out true or false, are you equal to this other cell? If that's true, then I want, now we have to remember, if we're going to type in balance, what is it that we have to do to text in formulas? Put it in double quotes. The formula will not recognize in balance unless you put it in double quotes. That's what we want in the cell if it's true. If it's false, which means we have some trouble, right? Not in balance, or whatever you want. Maybe you'd put debits don't equal credits. Now, notice I spelled something wrong. If I Control Enter, right now, if I were to highlight these cells and hit F7, the keyboard shortcut for spell check, notice it says, spell check is complete, you're good to go. That's because once you put text into a formula and enter it, spell check won't find it. But if I'm in edit mode, if I hit F7, it can find it. Now I'm going to be careful here. This is trying to correct the spaces and everything. For example, right there, there's an extra space. But now I see how to spell it, so I'm going to click Escape, and I'm going to change it. Control Enter. So not in balance. As soon as I track down the error and change it to a 0, boom, it tells me true for the logical formula and in balance for the if function. One of two things, in balance phrase, not in balance phrase. One of two things, 500 or 0. Now let's go over to this other sheet, if 2, and we want to see similar examples, but we have to copy them down the column. So this is our payroll sheet, right? We want to know, did each employee surpass the $20,000 hurdle? So I want a logical formula in this column. Equal sign, are your sales greater than or equal to the hurdle? And I have to lock this with the F4 key. Control Enter, double click and send it down. Go to the last cell and hit F2. That's working perfect. Now I want yes or no. So here we want one of two words. So equals if and the logical test. Well, it's going to be the same logical test. Are your sales greater than or equal to? Now, whether or not it's equal or not depends on the language in your contract. If it says greater than, then it's the greater than symbol. We want equal. We have a nice boss. So if we make it exactly 20,000, we get the bonus. If our sales are greater than or equal to our hurdle, F4 to lock it, then what do we want? In double quotes, yes. That's the value of true. That's the first possible thing that can go into the cell, comma. Otherwise, the value of false, no. This is the second thing that can go into the cell. One of two words. Double click and send it down. Click in the last cell, F2. It's working perfect. We have yes, no. Now, what about the bonus amount? This is a practical example. Many payroll spreadsheets around the world have formulas like this. If, hey, the employee sales, are they greater than or equal to whatever the hurdle is in B9 locked? I'm going to hit the F4 key. The value, if true, whatever's in cell B10, and I'm going to hit F4 to lock it, comma. And the value of false, we're typing in 0. Close parentheses, Control Enter, double click and send it down. Go to the last one in F2. The if function saves so much time. What if you had hundreds of employees? You would not want to go and I this. Lots of mistakes that way. Plus, that would be slow. If function, that's fast. So anytime you have one of two things, the if function can come to your rescue. Now, there's some other things that we can do with the if function. And after you finish Business 216 and you go on to Highline Excel Class Business 214, we'll talk about other things the if function can do. If you can't wait, Excel Magic Trick 452 has 16 examples, some amazing things that the if function can do. All right, this is our second to last, our penultimate Excel basic videos. Our next video, which will be our last video for Excel, will be about VLOOKUP. All right, see you next video.